We know for a fact that Republicans are so obsessed with communist China. Do you think the GOP are trying to push for a war with China? And what do you think the ramifications would be if there is such a war? There's a lot of people in Washington, D.C., mostly Republicans, but I will throw in there's probably a couple of Democrats in that group, too, that just love war. Right? War is good for business. War is good for the corporate media here in the United States. War is good for the defense industry. War makes a lot of people a lot of money. So it doesn't matter what country it is. There are people in D.C. with a lot of power that are always going to push for more war. Now, with regard to China, do I think it's possible we would ever go to war with a real, genuine superpower like China? No. Because that would be absolutely devastating. It would be devastating to us in the United States. It would be devastating to China. It would disrupt supply chains all over the world. And I'm talking about probably for years or decades to come. You know, two big producers of goods, China and the United States, suddenly at war with one another. And of course, Russia's going to jump in with China. We're going to get our NATO allies to jump in with us. Suddenly you've got Europe in peril, like right in the middle of everything. So it would be complete and total devastation if we were to go to war with China. But I think a lot of it is not necessarily because we're planning a war, because they want a war. I think it's simply bloviating, right? The United States talks a big game on China. Like, oh my God, they're horrible. The human rights abuses are terrible. They're communists. They're a bunch of horrible people. And then, of course, they sit down at the meetings and they're like, oh my God, how are you doing? Oh, it's been so long. You're so cool and great. I love you. Hey, thanks for all the things you send to us. Thanks for buying stuff from us. Hey, everything's cool. Behind the scenes, it's not what it looks like when you watch it in the media or when you see these Republicans spout their idiotic talking points. You know, Trump Jr., by the way, came out recently and started ranting and railing against China, forgetting the fact, of course, that his dad, actually his family's companies, got $5.4 million from China just while Trump was in office. Trump and Ivanka, his daughter, secured 18 different trademarks from China while he was president of the United States. So they actually love China. They love to rail against them and act like it's the worst place in the world, but secretly they love it because China gives them a lot of money. China has a lot of money. China also, as I said, they've got a lot of human rights abuses. They have a ton of problems in that country. But that's not something that the United States military needs to get involved in because China also has a very powerful military. So we won't ever actually do it. But Republicans, and again, even some Democrats, are probably going to keep up the scare tactics about China because it's good for business.
Thanks for watching, everyone. And well, here comes the awkward part at the end of the video where I ask you to like, comment, and share, and subscribe for more content from Ring of Fire. Also, you should consider becoming a member for some exclusive content and perks, including early access videos and exclusive videos. Check out the link in the description.